I'm Rip.
I'm Trey. And here's to new beginnings.
This water was good. I just want to let y'all know how hard this was, because if you go to his Instagram page, it is nothing there.
I had to have a drink to loosen up, so bear with me. But we gonna do this.
So Tremont and I met in 2006, so we're gonna fast forward to 2020. And you know, my career has, I got to a point where I'm successful, right? Where I deem I'm successful in life. And you know, things are slowing down, so you know, I'm ready to start having kids and have a family.
Britt and I met in 06. Things were a lot different then. She was more so on the chasing end of the stick. Fast forward to 2020. We in a whole different lane where I'm chasing her. And
Trey and I, we had this discussion about, you know, how beautiful it would be to have one kid.
I've always wanted a family, and I was in a place where I felt like I was ready for a family.
You know, planning about how many kids we want in the future. So, needless to say, we agreed. Trey shot the club up, and now we're here.
I took matters into my own hands.
The doctor says she sees a shadow. So this so-called twin me.
This is so crazy. Oh, a two for one.
Yeah. My mind is going crazy because I'm like, okay, is something wrong? And she's like, just give me a second. She's looking back in there. She's like, oh, exactly what I thought. I'm like, well, what did you think? Like, what did you, like, what's going through your mind?
But here you can see both babies.
And she was like, oh, so just nonchalant. You're having twins. I expected one baby, but now you're saying two? After the doctor told me the news, I'm still shocked and I'm processing. So when I step out, I don't call.
So normally, this time of day, I would have had 17 missed calls if I can't pick up. Oh, it's an issue. You know, the usual stuff. But it's been 5-6 hours. I haven't got a call. I don't know what's going on. I don't know if she all right. Now I'm reaching out to her. She not responding, she not answering. I'm lost, I'm confused. I don't know what the hell is going on.
I'm driving home and I'm processing this. And
which is odd as hell. 19 calls a day to zero. I'm like, damn, did we pay the phone bill? Did we forget something? I thought it was on auto pay. I don't know what the hell is going on.
But it was just so much on my mind. Like, I'm in shock, twins. Now we need to figure out what we're having. So the whole plan was to do a gender reveal for us to find out together. And long story short, go to the doctor. And, you know, the doctor's like, do you want to know the genders? I'm 20 weeks. Of course, I want to know the genders. I'm like, no, put him in the envelope. It's COVID. He can't come. We're going to figure out together. I come home, envelope sealed, put it on the table. He comes home thirsty from lunch. Remind you, this is a Thursday. Gender reveal is on Sunday.
I was thirsty out the gate. That's why we in this situation. But go ahead.
So he come home from lunch, thirst box here, and he's like, I'ma open it. I'm like, well, I mean, you didn't get to go to any of the visits, so I mean, I guess this is a compromise. You know what your response tells me?
What?
It's two girls.
Nah. I'm happy. As long as they come out healthy.
I don't know. I wanna know. I don't wanna know. Two boys?
Oh. Yes, sir.
I wanted a girl. I was just as thirsty as he was. So he looked in it. He had this crazy reaction. Then I looked in it, and so the whole time, we are lying to our family, telling our family we don't know the genders until Sunday. So I'm making bets with my sister. I'm like, 200, that is, you know, these are the genders, right? And then my mom is like, I think it's this. I'm like, okay, bet 100. So I already know, but I'm not gonna really take their money, but you know, then I tell my little brother.
Roughest week of my life, because I don't lie.
Now I feel like super blessed, no matter the genders, because I'm gonna throw this out there. When I found out that we were having two, I wanted a boy and a girl. I named them Zeke and Zoe. I didn't think of any other names because I was like, in my heart of hearts, God bless us with twins. He gonna give us a boy and a girl. It's a 2-for-1. And so I haven't thought of any names. So I'm gonna need y'all help for that.
Get them cleats out.
Right?
The little cleats out.
Yeah, no, we don't gotta worry about no little girls. What's that? Twin boys. Now we're here, right? Bundle of joy. I will say.
Bundles.
Bundles. Yeah, I gotta start correcting myself. You know, I mean, I was shocked, but I mean, other than that, like, I just felt literally so blessed. Like, it's just crazy. We're having a baby with my high school sweetheart, somebody that I've been with over 14 years, and to really love you, to really know you, to know like how great of a parent like you're gonna be, and we gonna be, right?
Oh, yeah, make me feel good about myself.
I mean, I see you with Ken. You gonna be a good dad.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
In the beginning, I definitely just wanted two healthy babies when I found out we were having twins, but you know, deep down inside, you know, man, I always want two boys. I wanted two little rascals. I could take them to the gym with me, get swole. We could, you know, do them type of things. But I definitely wanted her to have something that would make her happy and something that would make me happy. But at the end of the day, these two healthy boys that we have are going to make us happy. And it's going to be a dream come true.
They say boys love their mama forever.
Yeah.
So you know, they say the girls love the dad, the boys love the mom. So y'all stay tuned because we might gotta try again. All right, thank you guys. Love you all. Thank you for watching.
Like, follow, subscribe.
That shit got me hot.